the collection of the filaments from the cocoons, grouping and binding them into a compact yarn and then winding it into a convenient package is called silk reeling and is done on the silk reeling machine. Based on the process involved, silk reeling machinery can be classified into two types: A, simultaneous process; B, sequential process. In this simultaneous process, the operation of softening and brushing and cooking and unwinding the filaments is carried out simultaneously in hot water, example charka reeling process. Whereas in the sequential process, the operations are separated. After cooking separately by any of the cooking methods, the softened cocoons are brushed and the cocoons with the filament ends are transferred to the reeling basins, example cottage basins, multi-end machines, automatic and semi-automatic reeling machines. Of the above machines, the charka silk reeling is the oldest method of reeling still in vogue because of its simplicity, economy and productivity. Before to going about the types of reeling, let us briefly discuss about the important parts involved in the reeling process. Reeling basin. Reeling basin is a vessel containing water in which the cooked cocoons are kept for reeling. In charka reeling, the cooking and reeling are done in the same vessel. By doing this, the water in the reeling basin will be polluted early. Hence, water in the reeling basin should be replaced frequently. By doing this, additional expenditure for fuel to boil the water in the basin, which will increase the cost of production. Formation of reeling end. As per the required denier of silk thread, the required number of bales from as many cocoons are collected and are passed upwards through the guide eye of a threader, which may be either a porcelain button or a jetty board. In charka, the filaments pass through a threader or tarapatti and come out as a thread. In filature or cottage basins, they pass through jetty board and the thread formed then goes through the button, croiser pulleys, croiser and distributor, and finally it will be passed onto the reel. Each place where thread is formed in the reeling basin is called an end. The cluster of cocoons from the thread is formed at each end is called a rosette, and the balloon is that where the conical formation of filament passed from rosette to the threader. Coming to the threader, porcelain button or tarapatti. In filature or cottage basins, a porcelain button with a small hole is used as a threader, whereas in charka reeling, a thin iron strip made with small holes is used as a threader, which is generally called as tarapatti. Coming to the jetty board, this is invented in France an American engineer Serrell. Later on, this device is developed and brought into the practice. In charka and cottage basins, there is no special mechanism to attach the filaments, except the reeler has to attach the filament to the balloon below the threader, which is drawn up by friction in reeling operation. It is a skill, and the quality of silk thread would be affected if the casting is not perfect. Silk size loses uniformity, neatness, and it is very difficult to maintain the number of ends at a time. Hence, in all the modern reeling machine, the jetty boat is adopted. Coming to the croiser, it is a process of intertwining of silk thread by twisting mechanism in a series of spirals. This will help to squeeze out the water from the raw silk and makes it dry. To remove gum spots and to make the silk filament lustrous. Croiser makes the thread cohesive and lustrous. There are two types of croisers. Number one, chambon type of croiser. Number two, travelletta type of croiser. Coming to the distributor, as said earlier, the croiser helps to remove moisture content of raw silk. However, still the silk filament contains some more moisture. If the silk is accumulated on the reel, plastering or ribbing occurs. This will spoil the reeling quality. Therefore, to avoid this, a rod shaped device is arranged to distribute the thread uniformly on the reel and also helps to remove the moisture. Coming to the reels, the frame onto which the silk thread is reeled is called the reel. The size of reel in case of charaka is bigger than the cottage basin. The circumference of charaka reel is 150 centimeter and that of cottage basin multi-end reeling machine is about 60 to 80 centimeter. Coming to the speed of the speed of reel should be maintained constantly. The speed of reel depends upon the type of reeling machine, filament length, denier. The speed should be adjusted taking into consideration of the reelability and filament length of cocoon. High speed will increase the tension on silk and frequent breakages. Coming to the silk reeling, reeling is a process of unwinding of silk filament from the cocoon. Reeling process is an important activity. Depending upon the required denier of silk thread, filaments from number of cocoons are combined together and reeled. An efficient reeler will maintain the fixed number of cocoons per end to produce uniform denier silk. Reeling is carried out by distinctive methods: charaka, cottage basin, filature, and also automatic reeling machine. This is a conventional hand operated reeling system in the Indian silk reeling industry. Between 50 to 60% of Indian raw silk production is from this reeling device. It is a crude device made of locally available material occupying very little floor space. Generally, charaka is installed in the backyards of the reeler's house. The equipment is built by the local artisans and assembled by the reeler himself. Due to this reason, the charaka does not have any specifications or measurement and is wholly based on the convenience of the reeler. Each reeler owns 2 to 10 charakas. Coming to the charaka reeling process, low quality or defective cocoons are generally used for producing silk reeling on charaka. The yarn is coarse and highly defective and is mainly used as weft yarn in handloom. Water in the reeling vessel is heated to about 90 degrees centigrade. Reeler sits on the mud platform facing the reelers, boils a handful of steamed or unsteamed cocoons by immersing the cocoons in hot water using two thin bamboo sticks tied at one end. The reeler uses this bamboo stick in the form of chopsticks to boil and brush the cocoons. After removing the floss and obtaining a clear bevel and draws a groove of filaments through the tarapatti holes and coils with the groove of filaments from the neighboring thread once so as to get the chambon croiser. The individual ends are then passed through the traverse rod rings and tied onto the reels. Reeling is carried out to obtain hanks of about 50 to 60 grams in weight and is glazed, removes the hanks from the reel between the ribs of the reel. After the targeted production, the reeler removes the hanks from the reel by collapsing the reel spoke and the reeler tweezes out the yarn in the ribbed portion to separate them. The dry silk hanks look pulpy and bulky, which are then bundled for marketing. The production per day of approximately 8 hours ranges from 1 to 1.5 kgs based on the denier of the yarn referred as fine, medium or coarse. Generally, the workers are paid based on the raw silk produced or quality of cocoons converted into yarns. Even though the charkha reeling device is very simple and economical, it has more disadvantages than advantages. It is a manually operated reeling machine due to which reeling speed is not constant. As the yarn distribution mechanism is not a positive motion, the yarn on the hanks are laid in a highly irregular crisscross manner. The outer edges of the hanks are matted because the yarn laid in this region is almost parallel to each other. This is due to the lateral movement of the traverse stick at two loose end housed on a Y-shaped wooden support. In charkha reeling, there is no binding of filaments as the crozier has only one coil in it, due to which the end binding is not proper. As the filaments are not agglutinated, the yarn cohesion is very low and it has low tenacity. The end gathering device, namely the dharapatti, has large holes of more than 2 millimeter diameter through which large slubs easily enter the yarn path and to the hank, increasing the cleanness defects. The high temperature cooking and reeling bath restrains the reeler from dipping his hands in the bath. This results in over boiling of cocoons. Due to poor working conditions, in charkha reeling efficiency of the reeler is affected. To overcome all the defects of the hand reeling machine, improvements were made on the existing crude charkha. To ease the reeling operations and to improve the quality of the yarn, changes were made in the following aspects. Cooking and reeling operations were separated. After boiling the cocoons in a separate bath, the reeling is carried out in a low temperature bath. Small looped wires were mounted over the reeling basins to facilitate thread gathering instead of the dharapatti. Crozier pulleys are provided for introducing travelata type crozier. A metallic rod with thread guides was provided without any modification in the drive. The reel shaft and spokes are made of iron with wooden rods and fitted with ball bearings. The drive to the wheel is manual and with the bicycle pedal, chain and sprocket wheels. The quality of the yarn produced on this device is much better than the yarn produced on the conventional charkha, but lacked the bulky character. This is a development over the charkha hand reeling machine and falls under the class sequential process. In older machines, a single speed pulley was provided, whereas presently all cottage basin machines are provided with three-step pulleys to change the speed of the reels as and when required. From the step pulleys, the main shaft drive runs all along the length of the machine. Large drum wheels are mounted on the main shaft, one for each basin. The reel shaft mounted in the U bracket of the main frame as a compressed wood roller or friction roller, which rests on the drum wheel. The reel shaft rotates due to the frictional contact between the drum wheel and the wooden wheel. Each basin has about 6 to 8 reeling ends, and the yarn from each reeling end is wound onto a reel which is made of either molded aluminium or wooden reels as in the earlier version. Coming to the reeling process in cottage basin and filature, water in the reeling basin is heated by steam to a temperature of about 40 degree centigrade, or hot water at 40 degree is directly let into the basin by pipes. Cocoons which are boiled and brushed are then transferred into the basin. The operator sits on a stool and collects the filaments from the cocoons so as to get a clear bev and ties them to a small peg provided at the basin. The filaments are drawn from the cocoons based on the desired yarn denier and passed through the button hole after fixing the button in its holder. Then the filaments are passed over the top croiser pulley from the front and brought down beneath the lower croiser pulley, and a travelata type of croiser is inserted. After the croiser, the yarn is passed through a yarn distributor or guide and tied to the small reel. After all the reeling ends are fixed, the machine is switched on and disengaging clutch is released so as to rotate the reel shaft. As the winding is continued, new filaments are joined to the existing ones whenever the filament breaks or a cocoon is exhausted. The dropped cocoons due to broken filaments are gathered and sent for re-brushing once again. The temperature of water in the basin is maintained at lukewarm level by adding hot water or heating with steam. Slubs which may arise obstruct the movement of the yarn at the button or at the croiser level, and continuity of the yarn is broken. Then the reel shaft is stopped by disengaging the drum wheel. The slub is removed and the yarn rejoined by a knot after following the same yarn path. This system of reeling is commonly found in India in organized reeling units where steam is used for boiling and heating water in the reeling basin. They are called filature basins. Smaller units with hand driven machines or electrically operated machines without a steam boiler are called cottage or domestic basin units. The production of 20 to 22 denier raw silk yarn for 8 reeling hours from each basin is about 750 to 800 grams, and the manpower required varies from 1.75 to 2%. The multi-end reeling basin is a modified version of the filature basins to improve the production and quality of raw silk yarn. Each multi-end reeling basin has 10 to 20 reeling ends. 10-end basins are available in India, whereas in China, 20-end reeling basins are common. The structure comprises of three cast iron frames mounted one above the other with the facility for reeling on both sides of the machine. The first frame is the base on which the complete machine rests. The reeling basin is mounted on this frame. The second frame fixed in the center mounted on it is a stainless steel plate for jetty boat, croiser pulley and button holder. The drive for the jetty boat is housed on the center frame. The top frame supports the main shaft, croiser pulley, stop motion device, the clutch mechanism support for reel shaft, steam pipes for drying silk, etc. The driving head of the machine is housed in a metal sheet enclosure at one end of the machine. It consists of an electrical motor for driving a variable speed drive. The drive to the reel shaft is transferred through V belts, sprocket and chain, and helical gears. A planetary gear is provided for the traverse mechanism. A techno generator is also mounted for measuring the speed of the reel shaft. The reeling basin is made of stainless steel with a dimension of 42 centimeter breadth into 12 centimeter width into 16 centimeter height, which holds about 40 liters of water. Partitions are made in the basin to separate the cocoon unwinding portion and cocoon standing bath. The basin is connected with water and steam pipe to provide hot water for the reeling operation. A drain valve and an overflow pipe is provided for the continuous flow of water which helps to avoid chemical concentration of water in the reeling basins. Coming to the reeling process, water is filled into the reeling basin and heated by allowing steam so as to attain a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. The brushed cocoons are then transferred into the tray in the cocoon standing bath and the bevs cleared so as to get a clear filament from each cocoon and tied to the peg provided on the basins. During the reeling operation, water inlet is kept open slightly so that fresh water is allowed into the reeling tray. The excess water from the tray is eliminated by the outflow arrangement provided in the basin. The bath temperature is also maintained at 40 degrees Celsius by opening the steam valve. The pupae after the cocoons are completely reeled settle at the bottom of the basin, which is removed. Similarly, the dropped cocoons are also collected and sent for rebrushing. The multi-end reeling machine has been developed with the main objective of increasing the quality of the raw silk yarn. The production per person has been increased by increasing the number of ends. Filament ends feeding, dropped cocoons and pupae collection is manual in a multi-end reeling machine. To improve the yarn denier uniformity, the speed is kept low. Hence, multi-end can be termed as a slow speed machine. Automation for reeling was introduced in Japan during the 1950s in order to improve the quality of the Woltin hybrid cocoons and to increase the efficiency of reeling. With the introduction of the automatic reeling machines, the productivity of raw silk yarn per basin has increased remarkably, besides improvement in the quality of raw silk. By 1965, most of the silk reeling machines in Japan has switched over to automatic reeling machines, and Japan emerged as a leading exporter of high quality raw silk yarn to Western countries. In an automatic reeling machine, the operation of brushing the cooked cocoons, gathering of the filament ends, feeding the filament to the reeling ends, dropped cocoon and pupae separation are mechanized, thereby reducing the manpower, the requirement considerably. A reeling machine having 240 to 400 reeling ends requires 4 to 10 operators for fixing the stopped ends and to see that the cocoons are arranged for feeding the reeling ends. Denier detection of the yarn being reeled is another major breakthrough in automatic reeling. The denier detector device, or a denier indicator, senses the denier of the yarn before winding it to the reel. The main parts of an automatic silk reeling machine and the operations are: grouping part, freshly cooked cocoons and dropped cocoons are brushed in this part and the cocoons with filament ends are collected and transferred to the cocoon feeding part. The grouping part consists of grouping tube at both ends of the reeling machine and grouping equipment, the brushing device operated mechanically to pick the filament ends from the cocoon surface. Coming to the cocoon supply part, this is a device to supply the cocoons to the reeling part based on the requirement of the cocoons at the reeling end, which is sensed by the denier detecting mechanism. The cocoon supply mechanism can be classified into two types: A, cocoon feeding from a standing bath, and B, cocoon supply from the conveyor buckets. Coming to the cocoon filament and feeding apparatus, the function of this part is to add a single filament end to the group of filaments being reeled as and when the denier of the yarn is reduced due to filaments being breakage or the cocoon is exhausted. The operation of feeding is in coordination with the operation of the denier sensor. The cocoon filament, which is bound to the binding rod, is gathered by the jetty boat and the filament is joined to the reeling end whenever the picking lever strikes the picking fork. Coming to the reeling part, the filament passing through the jetty boat tube passes through the button and over the Kreiser pulleys to form a travelator type Kreiser and then passes through the denier sensor. The denier sensor is a device which detects the denier of the yarn being reeled before it is wound onto the reel. Two types of sensors have been developed, A, the constant number cocoon type, and B, the constant denier type. The constant denier type is more common. Coming to the denier sensor, the device consists of two glass plates with the inner surface highly polished, a central brass axle, polyester film placed between the glass plates, a detecting pin fixed on one side of the glass plate and to the washer on the other side. A balancing weight is placed next to the detecting pin and the whole assembly is tightened in its place with a lock nut screwed to the axle. Coming to the dropped cocoon and pupae clearing part. In automatic reeling machine, the bottom plate of the reeling part is an inclined position. This is to facilitate the sliding of the dropped cocoon. If the pupae of an exhausted cocoon is to be slid to the end of the reeling tray, as the cocoon are cooked for sinking in the reeling bath, they will sink to the bottom when dropped and move to the end of the tray. A set of collector buckets move throughout this length of the machine, drawing the dropped cocoons and pupae and feeds it to a cocoon pupae separating device fixed at both ends of the machine.